are these functions f and g here too one or too many? And are they one two or many two? So are they one to one or many to many, etc.? You will learn the answers to this question in this video, as well as a method to answer these questions for different functions. So, try it yourself first. Is the function f too one or too many? Well, let's give it a try. If we set in polar form as like this, phi argument of z, so the principal value, k in z, any number in z, then we can compute the image f, where k is still in z. And now we see that our answer depends over here on which value of k you are taking exactly. So that means that with one value of z, you get more different answers. So the function is too many. For example, if you start with z equals 1, then your f of z will be e to the power k times 6 pi I over 5, k is in z. If you pick k equals 0, you get that the function value equals 1. If you pick k equals 1, you get e to the power 6 pi I over 5, which is a different value. So f of z is too many. And to how many, actually? How many different images does one point in the domain has? Well, you can give it a try. So for k equals 0, you find this value over here. And for k equals 1, you get this value over here. For k equals 2, you get this value over here. For k equals 3, you get over here. And for k equals 4, you get over here. And if you take k equals 5, you're back at 1 again. So you see we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different values. So the function f of z is 2, 5. Well, 5 is already many for a mathematician. So next question. Is this function f 1, 2, many, or many, too many? Well, let's give it a try, whether it's 1, 2, or many, 2. So if you have fz1 equals fz2, does it imply z1 equals z2? If it does, then our equation, our function is 1, 2, many. And if it doesn't, our function is many, 2, many. Because if fz1 equals fz2 implies z1 equals z2, then there are not different sets mapping to the same point. Well, let's give it a try. Let's again write our sets in polar form like this. And we can write our f of z in polar form. And we see that the equality fz1 equals fz2 implies that the radii have to be the same. R1 to the power of 3 over 5 equals R2 to the power of 3 over 5. And R1 and R2 are just real numbers. But we also see that what's in the exponential, e to the power rubbish is equals e to the power some other rubbish if rubbish and other rubbish differ by a factor of 2 pi. So 3 times phi 2 over 5 equals 3 times phi 1 over 5 plus some multiple of 2 pi. And if you take, for example, well, R1 equals R2 equals 1, R's have to be the same, don't care about that one too much. And but if we set phi 1 equals to 0, then we can set this combination equal to 2 pi, or phi 2 equals to 10 pi over 3. And if you compute that, you get z1 equals 1, and z2 equals e to the power 4 pi I over 3. So what do you have? Z1 and z2 are different, but they are still mapping to the same point in the range. So our function is many, 2, many in this case. So what's actually going on? Your e to the power 4 pi I over 3, if you do that to the power 3 over 5, first to this value, and then if you increase k, you go on to this one, and then to that one, etc. And if you start with 1 as your first value, you start at 1, and then you continue. So you are actually, with those different values in the domain, you map to the same five values, but you go through them in a different order. But still, different values in the domain map to the same set of values in the codomain. So our function f is many to many. What about z to the power 5, our second function? Is this one? One to one, many to one, one to many, or many to many? First question, is our function to one or to many? Let's apply the same strategy. We set again z in polar form, find a principal value of the argument, k in z. We compute the function value, r to the power 5. And then we see now we have a k times 10 pi I. But e to the power k times 10 pi I is always 1, no matter what value of k you take. So you just get r to the power 5, e to the power 5 times phi, independent of k. So whatever k you take, you always get 1 image. So this value is nicely 2, 1. Now, second question, is this function 1 to 1 or many to 1? So are different values mapping to the same function value or not? Well, let's try the same trick. This f of z1 equals z2. Well, let's try. We again set z1 and z2 in polar form. We impose that the function values are the same. And then we know that r1 has to be equal to r2 because r1 to the power 5 equals r2 to the power 5. But we again have something similar. 5 phi 2 equals 5 times phi 1 plus a multiple of 2 pi, where k is any number in z. And again, we can do a similar trick. Don't care too much about r, we just set it to 1. We can choose phi 1 to 0 and phi 2, for example, to 2 pi over 5. And then we see z1 equals 1 and z2 equals e to the power 2 pi I over 5. If you take those to the power 5, you get in both cases 1 to the power 5 or e to the power 2 pi I, which is also 1. In both cases, you get 1. So e to the power 2 pi I over 5 and 1 both map to 1, which means that our function is many to, and we knew already that it was to 1. So our function g of z is many to 1.